included.
What are the movie blockbusters in Paris these days? Total Recall, Another 48 Hours, Gremlins 2, all the Hollywood hits of the season. It's the same from Brussels to Bangkok. American movies dominate the big time, big screen. It's getting harder for everyone to compete with the American mega hits. But behind the billboards, there's a new business reality in film and video. Like every other industry, this one is going global. And there is one area where Canada has a good chance to be a player in the 90s, on the small screen.
Run a rehearsal from the top.
In fact, our film industry is quickly becoming our television industry. Here's one Canadian TV show that Parisians are watching. Border Town, a Canada-France co-production, just one of the many international production deals the Canadian companies have won lately. There's never been more opportunity for us to make television or to make profits.
There are going to be satellites orbiting the Earth that have 50 or 100 signals on them, and the challenge will be to have programs in an industry that's healthy enough, producing enough programs to get our shows onto those satellites so they can be seen throughout the world.
All right, may we try it, kids?
If the Canadian industry can grab a share of the profits to come, it won't have to rely on government handouts to stay alive.
This industry is in a period of transformation. Its growth is phenomenal, and it will be based on private sector profits. There's no doubt in my mind at all.
Remember what we were a decade ago? Hollywood North. The Americans flocked to Canada. We had a cheap dollar, good technicians, and generous tax breaks.
Action!
They passed off our cities as American, used American police cars in the shots, even trucked in garbage to make the streets look more like home. But now it looks like the early trade-offs were worth it. We learned to make films and television from the best in the business.
Whereas in the past, for decades, we had provided so-called below-the-neck services. We carried the plywood and we painted the sets and we hauled the cameras around. A few years ago, Canadians began to take on roles of ownership. We began to be the producers. We began to direct the films and we finally began to write.
The plan was to train an industry that could turn out top-notch Canadian feature films. But when Ottawa changed the tax rules 3 years ago, the movie money dried up. But money men like Don Starr can still find funding for television. He raised $30 million this year.
TV is a business. It's a producer's medium where you produce for X dollars, you have the whole world to sell it to recoup your costs. The movie business is gambling.
After all, TV shows are usually pre-sold to networks. You don't have to pray for a hit at the box office. Investors like that. But still, there's never enough money in Canada. So Canadians have learned another skill, the art of international co-production.
Because Canada is relatively small, we have always had to be a co-production country. We never could afford, by and large, to pay for things entirely in Canada. So our skills, not only as a company but as an industry in Canada, are now the skills that are in demand around the world.
Canada's Gemini Awards have celebrated our international reach.
Ich bin keine Bohnenstange.
And with new private stations emerging in Europe and transnational satellites only a few years away, the marketplace is getting bigger all the time. And we have one big advantage.
No, I don't even mind taking two scripts.
All those years of working for Hollywood means we can deliver an American-style production that the rest of the world wants.
We've definitely found a niche and we're respected. We're good suppliers of programming to our own market and to the American market and to the European market. And it's not at all a stigma to be from Canada. It actually is a great benefit to be from Canada when you're at MIP in Cannes for the television market or anywhere else.
Stand by.
But hold on. Getting our share of international deals is right, about to get much tougher.
Action!
It's like a movie plot. Just when a happy ending seems a sure thing, new danger appears. In this case, the Americans, now our biggest co-producers, will soon become our biggest competitors in the international television market.
now, with the fragmentation of the American market, with so many more channels, pay TV, pay-per-view, satellite, free TV, very few broadcast entities have a market big enough to support the cost to produce their programming. So now, the Americans are being forced into international co-production.
Soon, not only will Parisians be watching American movies on the big screen, they'll see France-US co-productions on TV.
And action!
There's no doubt the competition's going to get fierce, but Canada's never been in a better position to compete. We're making more and more homegrown shows like this one.
Mark.
Rolling.
And the changes coming to television in the 90s will give our industry the best shot it's ever had to succeed. And finally, make some profits. For Venture, I'm Linda Sims.